Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with our maths lesson number 4, linear equations in two variables. In earlier class we have studied for linear equation in one variable. Linear equation in one variable. So let us revise this. What are the linear equation in one variable? An equation contains only one variable, and highest power of the variable is 1 are called linear equations. Do you remember all those things? So linear equation in one variable, we have studied that it has what, power 1, and that of the only single variable is involved. So for example, we have 2x plus 5 equals to 0. Here, how many variables are involved? Only one, that is x as a variable, and power of this x is what? 1. Then suppose t plus 3 by 2 is equals to 4. This is also what? We have here t as a single variable, and power of highest power of this t is what? 1. So likewise, we have studied this linear equation in one variable. Now, the solution of an equation also we have studied. The solution of an equation, suppose I'll take this equation as it is, 2x plus 5 equals to 0. This is an equation. Now, solution of an equation is nothing but the root of the equation. So, while solving it, we have seen the different methods, right? So that of balancing an equation means when we are adding or subtracting on one side, that is LHS and RHS, because of this equal to sign we have two sides, right? One is LHS and another is RHS. So while if suppose I don't want this 5 plus 5, so what I will do, I'll subtract from both the sides. Then this 2 we don't want, that time what we will do, we will divide on both the sides. That is the one way we have seen. And another way is what? Transposing. That method also we have seen. So, I'll use here that of the transposing method to solve the equation. So, this plus 5, I'll here take up. So, it becomes minus 5. We will get here now x value we are finding. Now, that is the root of the equation. So, minus 5 upon 2, because 2 is multiplied. So, we have got here that of divide, right? So, this whatever we have got, this is called as solution of an equation or we say that is root of the equation, root of an equation. Now, if it is asked, represent on the number line. So, how we will represent it on a number line or just show it on a number line? See, whenever we draw a number line, at that time we have to use it for that of the pencil and scale. So, we will show your 0, 0's left side, all negative numbers we will show with equal distance, and that of the right side we will show that of all positive numbers. Now this minus 5 by 2, where does it lie? It will lie in between minus 2 and minus 3. So here in between it will show. We will show minus 5 by 2. And this is what? Root of the given equation. Now we will move ahead that of the linear equation in two variable. I will give you here one example, that is there is a match played in between India and Sri Lanka, right? Two players, Indian players, two Indian players scored 176 runs, right? And it is asked to represent it that of the in the equation form. How we will represent it in the equation form, right? See here what we have, whatever the two Indian players, they together. Now in maths, this together word means what? How we will express together means what? Addition, right? So we will add them, whatever their scores, plus equals to what? 176. Now do we know one of the players score? Don't know, right? So what we will do, that of both of them we will take as a variable. So for one player we will take x, and another player score we will take y, and plus y I have done because together, so that is together score is 176, right? So here these are the two different variables I use, that's why it is the two variable linear equation in two variable. Now linear word we have seen, that is what? The power should be 1. The power, both variables power is what? 1. So let us have that of the standard form of linear equation in two variables. What will be the standard form of this linear equation in two variables? Right now only here written, x plus y is equals to 176. This is the math, that of the equation form we have written, or the mathematically we have expressed. Now let us write that of the standard form, ax plus by plus c equals to 0. Right? This is what? A standard form of a linear equation in two variables. Right? Here a, b, c are the real numbers. This a, b and c, these are what? Real numbers. And that of what we have, we'll write here, a, b, c are real numbers. Now everyone knows that of what are the real numbers. And one more thing, that is what? A should not equals to 0, as well as B is also should not equals to 0. Right? Agar if A equals to 0 ho jata hai, agar dete hai, ya B is equals to 0, it will be no longer that of linear equation in two variable. It becomes linear equation in one variable, or simply a constant term will remain. Right? So we will see the example in this way. Let us see. I'll write here linear equation in two variable. For that few examples, already one example is given, that of the how to represent it. Right? So 3x plus 4y plus 5 equals to 0. Then here see, x and y, these are the two variables, different variables are used. Then minus x plus y equals to minus 1, root 2x plus that of the root 3y equals to root 5. All these are what? Linear equation in two variables. Like we have seen that for the linear equation in one variable, that which equations we will call it as a linear equation in one variable. The same conditions we will see for the which equations we will call it as linear equation in two variables. Suppose we got r 1 upon x plus 1 upon y equals to 6. Can we call it as a linear equation in two variable? Yes? No, na? So, here if we solve this one, if we simplify it, so we will get what? That of the degree somewhat 2 or that of the different degree, right? So, on simplification, it becomes x plus y equals to 6y, right? If I simplify this one, so y will multiply here and x will multiply here and it becomes what? 6xy. This one I will transpose, right? So, is of degree 2. So, we will not consider as a what? This is an as a linear equation in two variable. Even that of the root x plus root y. Suppose this is not a linear equation in two variable. Suppose I am taking root x plus root y is equals to that of the 4. What will be here? That power of this x will be half. Right? And y power will also be half. और अगर simplify करते हैं तो we will get that of the more than one power, right? So that's why we will not consider such a type of equations under what linear equation in two variables. Understood? Let us start with our exercise 4.1. The very first question I have written here: the cost of notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Write a linear equation in two variables to represent this statement. Now, in a textbook, it is given the hint that is, take the cost of a notebook to be x and that of the cost of a pen to be y. So, we will proceed over here that of let the cost of notebook, क्या कहा है cost of notebook? B x rupees or rupees x, right? And similarly the cost of pen rupees y, right? It is already given in the hint. Now we are just going to write the equation, right? So the cost of notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Now notebook is means what we take over here? Equals to, right? So we will take here, we will write here that according to the given condition, according to the given condition, whenever we are converting into the sign, that time what way this is actually converted into equal to sign, right? The cost of notebook, what we have taken cost of notebook? X. So let us write x in place of this notebook. I have written x equals to, is means equal to, twice means 2, right? Twice the cost of pen, what we have taken cost of pen? Is y. Twice, thrice, likewise word comes, no? That time that number is multiplied with the variable. Got it? So this is the required, or sorry, we are just going to write it in the standard form first. So x, now let us transpose it, x minus 2y equals to 0. So this is the required equation. This is the required linear equation in two variables. Understood this one? How we have got this one? So let us proceed with the question number 2 now. Express the following linear equation in the form of ax plus by plus c and indicate variables of a, b and c in each case. Right? So, I'll write here, first of all, question number 2, that from that we will take that of this second one. X minus y by 5 minus 10 equals to 0. This is what the given equation. Now we are just going to express our following linear equation in the form of ax plus by plus c equals to 0. So first of all we will compare it, right? So compare it with that of the given equation. So we'll have here comparing with what we are going to compare that of the standard form ax plus by plus c equals to 0. So let us compare. Now on comparing, what we have got, that of a is equals to, here we are just going to simply write it down, a, b and c value, right? So we will get here, first of all, so first of all check it whether it is in the form of this ax plus by plus c, it is there or not. If it is not there, then arrange it in that way, right? So here ax, it is x, then we have by means y by 5 we have, and c means minus 10, it is there, means already it is given. We are going to write it down that of the a, b and c values, right? So a here, what, there is no number, means simply 1. Now b is what here, b we will get what, 5, right? But does it 5, simply 5 it is here? No, actually 5 is written in the denominator, that's why we will get minus 1 upon 5. Got it, this one? And c is equals to minus 10. So likewise we are supposed to write. One more example we will see, that of third one, minus 2x plus 3y equals to 6. I'll write here. Minus, third one I'm taking here, minus 2x plus 3y equals to 6. This is the equation. Now just see carefully whether it is in the form of that of ax plus by plus c or not. So we will here first convert it into that form, right? So we will have here, first of all, minus 2x plus 3y, this 6 is shifted over here, it becomes minus equals to 0. Now compare it, comparing with ax plus by plus c equals to 0, right? With this standard form we are going to compare it, so to get a value, b value and that of the c value. So a will be what here? Yes, it becomes minus 2, right? Now so x is attached with that of the coefficient minus 2, so we will write here a value is minus 2, b value is simply 3 plus 3 and c is what? Minus 6. Got it, this one? So similarly we will see one more sum, that of fifth one, 2x is equals to minus 5y. Fifth one is 2x is equals to minus 5y. Is it in the form of that of ax plus by plus c? No. So let us first write it down in the form of ax plus by plus c. So 2x, this minus 5 we will shift it towards the left side. So minus becomes plus 5y, then equals to 0. Always remember that right side should not, means right side equal 2k, which should remain only zero. Means not a single term will remain towards the right side. Whatever right side terms are there, we are going to shift it towards left side. Now we got this one. Let us compare it. Comparing with ax plus by plus c equals to 0. Right? With this standard form we are going to compare. So a we will get, b and c value what we will get, let us see. A is what yours? A will be 2. Right? A is the coefficient of x here. So similarly x coefficient is here 2. Now y coefficient is b. So here y coefficient is 5. So we will write here that of the plus 5. What about the c? Is there any term to represent c? No. So at such a case we will write what? 0. Means that term is not available. So we will simply write it down 0. Understood this one? So one more last we will see, that is seventh one, y minus 2 is equals to 0. Y minus 2 equals to 0. Now the means equation, it is in the form of that of the ax plus by plus c. Right? Now let us have that of, we will write here ax plus by plus c in that form. Do we have here that of the x term? No, na. So we'll write here directly comparing with ax plus by plus c equals to 0. So what is our a here, b and c? Let us find out. Now ax, in the given equation ax term is not at all present, right? There is no term, so we'll write there 0. Right? Then by, do we have by? Yes, it is there. There is no coefficient for y, it means what? 1. And for c, we have minus 2. Got it this one? So in this way, we are going to solve exercise 4.1, that of the first and second question. Whatever the leftover sums are there from this exercise, solve it as an homework. Now, we will proceed for the solution of a linear equation. We have seen that for linear equation in one variable, see what I am saying, that of the linear equation in one variable has unique solution. Unique means what? It has one and only one solution.